Okay, to do printing of mail merge plus printing of labels, you need to have a data file for save created in an Excel file. I have some sample of it, but because we are using Kingsoft Office WPS Office, we cannot run mail merge directly from the Excel file, but we can copy the data to save it under the document format, which is the WPS document. You can save it using any paper size that you feel comfortable. You can view the whole data, doesn't matter, just paste it, right click, paste. It doesn't matter about the layout as long as the data are all inside. Alright, I purposely have something different. So I save this as, maybe I just choose, I save it on my C drive. I prefer to save it on my C drive. And I just name it as 3. Okay, 3. This is my data file on the document format. So after I created my data file on the document format, and I can close this and I create a new file. I can also, in this case, I need to go to reference to create a mail merge link to my data file on document. So I open the data source. So I just go to my directory, which I always use it on the C drive. I just created the 3 document. I just click 3 on the document, not the X, not the worksheet. I need take note of that. After I link the document, the data file, I can insert whatever is in the data file. Just for your notice, I think I opened the data file as well, so that for your easy clarification. Okay, maybe I make it to view as side by side, so you know what I mean. So I have all this, I make the view smaller. Okay, I have all this name, address 1, address 2, address 3, telephone. And this one you can create any name that you like. So I just use show the exit as an example using okay, when I come to here, I click here, I go back to reference, go back to mail merge, I click again and click again. Okay, now I come back to this mail merge format, I click insert. So you see all my field that I created for this document 3. I have name, address 1, address 2, address 3, telephone, and date of birth. As long as I link, open the data source and link this file together. So I just insert one by one. Okay, I just insert one. But it's very troublesome to, I cannot do anything here unless I closed it and I press enter and I do it, insert again. Then I insert the second one. Address 1, insert. But in order to save my time, I rather insert everything, then I do the editing. Okay, so editing and then do the editing. It's just for my example. And I just click enter, click here, enter, click here, enter, left click here, enter. So I make sure every feel that I have a space behind, because once the word mail merge detected, there's no record. So this may jump, all this may join together. Let's say I don't have 2 or 3 no data in these 2, so the system will automatically join them together. But in this case, I purposely leave a blank space here. Okay, after I've done so, so I can just run the mail merge from here. For all this data to this, follow this format, I click merge to new document. As I have this table, merge all. So it's start running. So you see another document come up. This is the new document 3. I maximize it, and I just show you the maybe I just did 3, this is 2. Maybe I just close this 2. Okay, save this 2 first. I save it under 4. Okay, save this under 4 and then close it. I just want to show you the side by side. Okay, so this is I want to synchronize scrolling. So this is 1. This is my first data. Okay, so London 101 second January. Okay, so this under this second data, join USA and all this. Okay, third data until the end. They all separated by different pages. So what I do is I just highlight all the pages by press control, holding the control and press A to select all of them. After that I release and then use my mouse to scroll up. It's all highlighted. I just right click this and do a copy. Okay, so I create another blank document. Okay, now I'm going to insert all my data into this this document. Okay, I forgot something. I need to do some changes on the I need to do some spacing for my primary file before I created that before. So I just enter, give a blank space in front in the first row, and then create a blank line, press space bar at the end of the record. This is to ensure that when I run mailmerge, I always have one blank line, and at the end of the record I have another blank space. It's just to ensure it. So make sure you put the space bar. Okay, every record. If you want to have an even length, later you know what I mean. Okay, after I finish, I go back to reference, go back to mailmerge, press again, and then merge to new document, click OK. So it start running. After that, I close this. Okay, I save this. Close this. I have all my data. I press Ctrl A and Ctrl C to copy and create a new file, and I just press keep text only. I paste as text only. So you see all my data, you have 2 blank space between every data. Okay, I just make this super long name just to create it for demo purpose. Okay, after I done that, okay, I think I'm gonna stop here. Then you follow the next clip.